Hello. This is Book Talk with Corbin. I'm your host. I'm going to talk a little bit more here about the whole reparations movement. And actually, I'm not just going to generally talk about it. I'm really going to address this to white conservative and white patriots throughout the United States of America. And I'm saying to all of you, listen and listen very carefully. First thing I want to start off by saying is that black and white conservatives, we're joined at the hip in saving this country from cesspool socialist ideology and gender ideology. I'm saying to black and white patriots, we are joined at the hip in defending free market, individual liberties, and the U.S. Constitution. Always remember that. We are joined at the hip in that struggle. We have, as Larry Elder often says, we have a country to save. He's absolutely right. And that's really a call to black and white conservatives, black and white patriots across the United States of America. We cannot ever tolerate anybody from within the conservative movement creating an artificial division between black and white conservatives. Can't allow that to happen. You know, if you got some, you just can't allow that to happen. Let me just leave it at that. Having said that, listen carefully. We should not be opposed to the reparations demand. What we should be opposed to is the government issuing reparations. What we should be opposed to is government mandates on reparations. It's not the government's role, per the U.S. Constitution, to say, okay, white taxpayers, we're going to force you, we're going to force you through taxes, legislation, whatever, to redistribute your wealth to black people. So you white folks who never owned slaves, we're going to force you to give money to black folks who never were slaves. And our authority to do that is in the U.S. Constitution. That's a lie from hell. The U.S. government has, the U.S. Constitution gives the government, federal, state, or local, no authority whatsoever to force people based on race to give over their wealth, private property, money to another group of people. That's what we need to vehemently oppose. Secondly, hey, we can engage in an intellectual debate about reparations. Is it just? Is it unjust? Is it right? Is it wrong? Actually, that debate's been going on within the black community for a long, long time, going back to the 19th century. But here's the bottom line. Here's the bottom line I'm calling upon the conservative movement, and in particular white conservatives and white patriots, to adopt. If you got some white folks out there who think that black folk will do reparations, listen. We need to tell them, well, cut the check. Cut the check. Why are you waiting for the government to do something that you think is the right thing to do? Cut the check. Find you a black individual, find you a black couple, find you a black family, and you know, you just say, hey, we believe, you know, I believe that as a white person, I owe you reparations. Here's a check. Or donation of stocks and bonds. Or some shares in a mutual fund. Or a piece of property, or a vehicle, and just voluntarily, on your own, give them the reparations. Why are you waiting for the government to do something you think is the right thing to do? It's ridiculous. It's absurd. It's unconstitutional. It's socialist. That's communism. If you're white, and you think you owe black, and you think that black people are due reparations? Cut the check. you go ahead and do that. And if you're white and you don't think that you owe black people reparations, God bless you. Let me tell you, let me make something real clear to you. I will lay my life down for you to take that position and make that position public. You are not a racist if you oppose, if you're white and you oppose reparations. That's an absurdity from lie. That's a lie from hell. That's ridiculous. But if you're a white person who does believe in reparations, let me tell you what's equally ridiculous. That you're wanting the government to force people to issue reparations to black folk. No, you believe in it? That's what you support? Okay, fine. I'll go to war to defend that. Just like I'll go to war to defend a white person who doesn't believe that. But if you believe you're white and you believe you black folks will do reparations, cut the check. Cut the check. Find you a black individual, couple, family. Say, hey man, here's some property. Okay. And I'm going to give you that this property as a reparations payment. Well, that's wonderful. Well, here's a vehicle or two, or maybe even a car dealership. Here, I'm going to give this to you as a reparations payment. Here's a check. Better yet, you know, my preference is that those white folks who believe they owe black people reparations, hey, give me some stocks. Go to stockpile.com. You can have so much stocks sent to me. You can email it to me or message it to me or mail it to me. There's no commission. Tell you the companies I prefer right now real quick. British American Tobacco, Kroger, and I wouldn't mind some Apple. Point is, though, is that what you believe? Hey, cut the check. What you waiting on? There's no sarcasm here. I'm not joking. I mean it. And so, but I'm saying to the conservative movement in general, and white conservatives and patriots in particular, that's what we should support. We should oppose government forced mandate, i.e. reparations. But we should support white folks who say, hey, they want to give money to black folks, you know, as a reparations payment. Man, we should, okay, fine, that's what you want to do. That's what you voluntarily want to do with your property. You go do it. And we should support white folks who say, well, you know, I don't think that's the right thing to do. I'm not going to do that. Hey, God bless you too. We're going to support you and defend you on that. And we'll support and defend black folk who are going to say, you know what, based on principle, I'm not going to accept any reparations payment from you. Based on principle, I just don't think it's right. So I'm not going to accept. Hey, God bless them too. We're going to support them as well. God bless them too. We're going to support them as well. That's the position I think the conservative movement, those are the positions I think the conservative movement in the United States should support, uphold, and proclaim widely and frequently. Very loudly. Those are the positions I think we should put out there. This is Book Talk with Corbin. I'm your host. Go to my website, booktalkwithcorbin.com, and subscribe to my channel, YouTube channel, Book Talk with Corbin, Book Talk with Corbin Sievers. Subscribe. I need some subscribers. Need some donations. And I really need for you to take some of my videos and share them with other folks.